بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم أما بعد رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما وارزقنا فهما آمين يا رب العالمين. My dear honorable respected brothers and sisters listening, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi
wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has once again brought us to His house. Allahumma laka alhamdu wa laka shukr. We should praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and thank Him and beseech and ask Him to bring us to His beloved house time and time again, inshaAllah. Ameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Faliq al-Isbah. وجعل الليل سكنا والشمس والقمر حسبانا ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who causes the dawn to break. فالق الإصباح وجعل الليل سكنا, and He has made the night for rest, a source, a time where a person سكنا, he rests, he feels sukoon, he feels peace. And وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ حُسْبَانَ, and the sun and the moon for reckoning of time. ذَلِكَ تَقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ, this is the measure set by Al-Aziz, the Almighty, Al-Alim, the All-Knowing. In a different verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, هُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ الشَّمْسَ ضِيَاءً, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the being who has made the sun a glow, a source of light. وَالْقَمَرَ نُورًا, and the moon a light. جَعَلَ الشَّمْسَ ضِيَاءً وَالْقَمَرَ نُورًا وَقَدَّرَهُ مَنَازِلَ لِتَعْلَمُ عَدَدَ السِّنِينَ وَالْحِسَابِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has determined for its stages. Why? So, لِتَعْلَمُوا عَدَدَ السِّنِينَ وَالْحِسَابِ, so we may learn the number of years and the calculation of time. In one other ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يُكَوِّرُ اللَّيْلَ عَلَى النَّهَارِ وَيُكَوِّرُ النَّهَارَ عَلَى اللَّيْلِ وَسَخَّرَ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرِ كُلٌّ يَجْرِي لِأَجْلٍ مُسَمَّى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He causes the night to overlap the day, وَيُكَوِّرُ النَّهَارَ عَلَى اللَّيْلِ, and He causes the day to overlap the night. And He is the one who has subjected the sun and the moon to a certain system. يُقَلِّبُ اللَّهُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَعِبْرَةً لِأُولِي الْأَبْصَارِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He causes the night and the day to succeed one another, to come after one another. If the day goes, the night comes. The night goes, the day comes. يُقَلِّبُ اللَّهُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ. And in this system, all the ayahs we mentioned, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has subjected the sun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered the moon, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered the day to come after the night. And subhanAllah, we have, when we're working in shift work, and we have, our shift work is 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. Majority of the time we wait for our colleague to come at 6 p.m. so we can leave. If it is a work activity where personnel is required at that time. So we wait 5 minutes, sometimes he's delayed or our colleague, you know, is stuck in traffic, we call, what's happening, I'm slightly dead, I'll be there in 2 minutes. So we wait until 6:05, 6:10, then our colleague comes and he takes over from 6 to 7. But subhanAllah, it has never happened where, subhanAllah, the day goes and the night, it takes time to come later. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يُقَلِّبُ اللَّهُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ وَسَخَّرَ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرِ ذَلِكَ تَقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ. When the day goes, the night comes, the night goes, the day comes. And the sun is set in a time where it's in a routine. And not because it was made, that what does Allah say? ذَلِكَ تَقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ. This is a system by Al-Alim, the All-Knowing, Al-Aziz, the Almighty. It cannot, without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, stay for a second later or leave a second earlier. This is the taqdeer, this is the system of Al-Aziz Al-Alim, the All-Knowing, the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And even يُقَلِّبُ اللَّهُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ, in the succeeding of the day and night, after the day, the night comes, after the night, the day comes. In this process, night, day, night, day, night, day, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say to us? إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَعِبْرَةً لِأُولِي الْأَبْصَارِ. In this system, there is an ibrah. There is a reminder, there is a source of reflection for who? لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ, those intelligent people. There is a lesson, لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ, for those people who have insight. In a hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just mentioning about time and how rapid time will go near to time, near to the Day of Judgment. The coming of the day, the coming of the night, this should make us ponder that our life is going fast quickly. We are aging and we are getting closer to death. And we realize more, subhanAllah, what prophecy Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تقوم الساعة حتى يتقارب الزمان. The day of judgment will not come until يتقارب الزمان, there is a contrast in time. فتكون السنة كالشهر, the year will feel like a month. والشهر كالجمعة, the month will feel like a week. وَتَكُونُ الْجُمْعَةِ كَالْيَوْمِ, the Jum'ah, the week, will feel like a day. وَتَكُونُ الْيَوْمَ كَالسَّاعَةِ, a day, one full day, will feel like an hour. وَتَكُونُ السَّاعَةِ كَالْضَمَرِ بِالنَّارِ, and 1 hour will feel like a kindling of the fire. You know, everything is ready. The whole dry wood is ready. All you have to do is touch that source of ignition to that wood and the fire will stop. So we feel it in our day, subhanAllah, how this week goes, how this month goes, subhanAllah, and the year. وَتَكُونُ السَّنَةُ كَالشَّهْرِ, that this whole year, we can remember Ramadan last year, it felt like a month. Less than a month. So this is a sign of Day of Judgment. لَا تَقُومُ السَّاعَةُ حَتَّى يَتَقَارَبَ الزَّمَانِ. Qiyamah will not happen, will not come until these signs are shown. There will be no barakat, no blessing in our time. But there is one thing that will create barakat in our time, and we will touch upon this maybe at the end of today, or next week, inshaAllah, bi-idhnillah. In another hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the rawi and the reporter of this hadith, Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتقارب الزمان, there will be contracts in time where time will become very close. يتقارب الزمان. وَيَنْقُصُ الْعَمُلُ وَيُلْقَ الشُّحُّ وَتَظْهَرُ الْفِتَنُ. Number one is, time will go past rapidly. Good deeds will decrease. وَيُلْقَ الشُّحُّ, greediness and being stingy will increase, will be thrown in the hearts of people. وَتَظْهَرُ الْفِتَنُ, and afflictions will appear. And in the last verse, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, last portion Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَيَكْثُرُ الْهَرْجُ, and al-harj will increase. The Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala, they say, أيمه. What is الهرج؟ Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says al-qatlu, al-qatlu, killings will happen, will increase. These are all happening. Fitan, we don't have to even explain what fitan is. I know, afflictions, where we live in social media. Al-harju, qatl, happening everywhere. So all these signs, all these prophecies, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prophesied more than 1400 years ago. Brothers and sisters, these are happening in front of our eyes. There are five characteristics of time. One is that time can be the longest, but at the same time, it can be the shortest. Time can be the fastest, but yet at the same time can be the slowest. When a person is, for example, waiting for trial, or he's going through a very hard time, these few minutes will feel like hours to him. When a person is enjoying himself, he's indulged in some sort of work, he looks up and 4 hours have gone past, especially with the phones nowadays. Now after Isha, we look at our phones, we look up, it's already 2 a.m. in the morning. We don't realize where our time is gone. And subhanAllah, we open the Quran, and we've seen that we read 3 juz, we look up, it's not even been 4 minutes, subhanAllah. With our phones, we don't want to look up because we're worried because, you know, if it's 10 o'clock, I need to go to sleep. If it's 10 o'clock, we're going to have to go to bed. But subhanAllah, after you read one safha of the Quran, Ya Allah, how long has it been? Read the safha, we look up. It's beyond 2 minutes. It can be the most neglected time, but same thing, it can be the most regretted. And the last thing about time, when it goes, it will never come back. And one author, a poet, he says, حياتك أنفاس تعد كلما مضى نفس منها انقضت له جزءا. He says, your anfas, your breath, the breath you take, tu'addu is limited and is counted. فَكُلَّمَا مَضَى مِنْهَا, every time you take a breath, you inhale, you exhale, وَحَفَرْ إِنْقَضَتْ لَهُ جُزْءَ, a portion of your life has gone away. Because we have come into this world, like the fourth author, fourth saying, gonna mention, we have come into this world with a bi'ajalin musamma, a certain appointed time. And in that time, a person will have a certain breath he can take, certain days he has, certain minutes he has. We read from Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he used to say, Yabna Adam innama anta ayyam, O Ibn Adam, O son of Adam, you, what are you? What is your principle? What is the base of you? Innama anta ayyam, you are just a number of days. He says, فَكُلَّمَا ذَهَبَ يَوْمٌ ذَهَبَ بَعْضُكَ, every day passes, every time a day passes from your life, ذَهَبَ بَعْضُكَ, a portion of you has passed. يَبْنَ آدَمْ إِنَّكَ لَمْ تَزَلْ فِي هَدْمِ عُمْرِكَ منذ يوم ولدتك أمك. He says, the day your mother gave birth to you is the day you starting decreasing in your age. As soon as your mother gave birth to you, that is the time where your time has started. You know, subhanAllah, you know, when you have timers, we have put a timer on for 5 minutes, press start, and as soon as you press start, the time decreases. You have 4 minutes, 10 seconds left. You have 4 minutes left. 3 minutes, 50 seconds left. SubhanAllah said, Abdul Dadi Allah Ta'ala, who saying that when he came into this world, it was like Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala had put a timer on you. You will live for 20 years. 20 years, then 19 years, 18 years, 70 years. Abu Darda رضي الله تعالى, in the first portion of this author of this saying, he says, إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ أَيَّامُ, you are just merely days. كُلَّمَا ذَهَبَ يَوْمٌ ذَهَبَ بَعْضُكَ, every time a day goes from your life, a portion of your life has gone. Let's say, for example, a person lives for 30 days. His whole life is based on 30 days. So his life is actually 30 parts. Every time a day goes past, one portion of his life has gone. He is left with 29 days, 29 portions of his life. 25 days have gone, he has 25 portions left of his life. So these years we have, these 60 years are broken up into months, months into weeks, weeks into days, days into hours. Hatta kid, these hours are given into seconds as well. Hayatuka anfasun ta'uddu, that your life are just merely breaths. Every time you inhale, you exhale, what happens? That portion of your life is gone. In Tafsir al-Qurtubi, عن الحسن بن الحسن, it is mentioned, لما أتى ملك الموت نوحا ليقبل روحه. When the Malak al-Mawt came to Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam to extract his ruh, Malak al-Mawt said to him, Ya Nuh, kam ishta fi dunya? He says, Oh Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam, how many years did you live in this world? He says, 300 qabla an ub'ath, that 300 years before I was made a prophet, wa alfa sanatin illa 50 aaman fi qawmi, and 950 years when I was sent to do da'wah. And afterwards, وَثَلَاثَمِئَةِ سَنَةٍ وَخَمْسِينَ عَامًا بَعْدَ الطُّوفَانِ, 300 before I was made a prophet, 950 when I was a prophet, and after the tufan, the flooding, 350 years. قَالَ الْمَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ كَيْفَ وَجَدْتَ الدُّنْيَا, he says, how did you find this time? Subhanallah, what did he say? قَالَ نُوحٌ عَلَيْهِ صَلَاةُ وَسَلَامُ مِثْلَ دَارٍ لَهَا بَابَانٍ دَخَلْتُ مِنْ هَذَا وَخَرَجْتُ مِنْ هَذَا. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah. He says, these maybe 1300 years, all these years I've spent in this world, Nuh, this Malak al-Mawt is asking him, how did you find this time? He says, like a dar, a house which has two doors. دَخَلْتُ مِنْ هَذَا وَخَرَجْتُ مِنْ هَذَا. I entered this door and wallahi, I left through that door. This is my life of more than 1,000 years. When the people will leave this dunya, قَالَ كَمْ لَبِثْتُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ عَدَدَ سَنِينَ, they will be asked when they go in the akhirah, how many years did you spend in this world? It could be anyone, from Nuh alayhi salatu wa, from Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, until the last person. People have lived for 1,000 years like Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam. People have lived more than 1,000 years. They will be asked, how many years did you spend in this life? Qalu, yes, sanin. They're asking about years. Qalu labithna yawman aw ba'da yawmin fas'alil adin. What comes into the mind? Forget about years. We stay in this world for one day, or even a part of a day, a portion of a day. They might even show if we live a full day or even a portion of a day. Fas'alil adin, those people who have just come now from this world, ask them, they may give you a better response. So this world, this life of 100, 200 years, 300 years, wallahi, it will feel like a day or even a portion of a day. What is our responsibility? Time and again, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullah. Oh, you who believe, oh, you have iman, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah guides us not once, many, many times. وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Every soul, every one of us should ponder and really concentrate, really have fikr and concern that what have I set forward لِغَدْ for tomorrow. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well aware, well acquainted of what you get up to, what you do. Our brothers and sisters, yes, we may think that Qiyamah is coming maybe in 2030 or 2040 or 2050, whatever year we have. We may think it's 20 years of coming in the future. We may think that it's maybe, you know, a month or 2 months. But one thing Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, that a person's Qiyamah will start when he passes away. And when will the person pass away? No one knows. Because if a person passes away, he cannot do anything. رَبَّنَا أَبَصَرْنَا وَسَمِعْنَا. Allah says in Surah Sajda, وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذِ الظَّالِمُونَ وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذِ الْمُجْرِمُونَ نَاقِسُوا رُؤُوسِهِمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you were to see the mujrimeen, the people who have transgressed the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, نَاقِسُوا رُؤُوسِهِمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ, lowering their gaze in front of their Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is also adab and respect. Nowadays, as youngsters, we know, we make eye contact to our parents, to our asatiza. This is not adab, respect. Especially when we have been told off, subhanallah, our young children. Yesterday I went to the masjid and subhanallah, the teacher was telling this student that stop laughing. He goes, Shaykh, it wasn't me. It was him. Subhanallah, this is not adab, this is not respect. نَاكِسُوا رُؤُوسِهِمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. Allah says, if you were to see those people that have transgressed the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their heads will be lowered down عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they will see the reality, they will say, رَبَّنَا أَبَصَرْنَا وَسَمِعْنَا فَرْجِعْنَا نَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا إِنَّا مُوقِنُونَ. Oh Allah, we have seen the reality. Now we are in the Akhirah, we have heard the reality. And inna muqinun, we have full yaqeen and full iman now. Ya Allah, give us one request. Let us make one request. Farji'na na'mal salihan. Let us go back into this dunya. Wallahi, we will do good a'mal. Farji'na na'mal salihan inna muqinun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, too late. لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب. Ya Allah, give me a respite for a few moments. What will I do? فأصدق, I will give charity in your path. وأكم من الصالحين. And wallahi, ya Allah, I will become from the صالحين. Allah says, ولن يؤخر الله نفسا إذا جاء أجلها. When your time comes, not a second later, not a second earlier. والله خبير بما تعملون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well aware of what we are doing. So brothers and sisters, time, wallahi, is flying past really quickly. And the only thing that will help us is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلْتَنْذُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ. Just the way at the end of every day or the end of every week, a company sits down, the shopkeeper, the owner sits down, that wallahi, what profit have I made today? What loss have I made today? Okay, I've made loss in this avenue. How can I stop that loss? But subhanallah, اِقْتَرَبَ لِلنَّاسِ حِسَابُهُمْ وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مُعْرِضُونَ. A day goes past, a month goes past, a year goes past. Ramadans upon Ramadans gone past. The same Abdullah 10 years ago, wallahi, is the same or even worse. After all those Ramadans going past. Why? Because we haven't made it an objective to change. Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim. Subhanallah. One more incident before we finish. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu at that time was a Muslim, but yet they knew, the Sahaba, the people that were Muslim, they knew at that time even that this Quran is the truth. So when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to pray tahajjud in the masjid at that time, they used to hide behind the sutur, behind the pillars, and listen to the Quran. Subhanallah, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu is listening to the Quran, live recitation of the Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And what does he say? That this person, what he's reading is a sha'ir, is a poet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed fresh ayat. وَمَا هُوَ بِقَوْلِ شَاعِرٍ. That these are not the words of a sha'ir, of a poet, Then that answer, that has been answered. Then he says, no, if it's not a poet, He's a fortune teller. Wama, Allah says, reveal again. Wama huwa biqawli kahin. These words are not the words of a fortune teller. Allah says, what are these words? Tanzeelun bi Rabbil Alameen. These verses are from Rabbul Alameen. Did he bring iman? No, he didn't. Why? Because إن الله لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغير ما بأنفسهم. We will change when we become 40. We will change when after Umrah, after Hajj. Allah says, if you don't have the niyyah to change, Allah will not change you. So Allah was talking to him directly. He did not bring iman. When did he bring iman? When his sister had brought iman, and he slammed the door open. He hit his sister. And his sister at that time was reading Quran. And he says, what were you reading? So this container that was upside down, it has turned around now. He has the intention, he has the curiosity, the what are you reading? And his sister said, no, do wudu first. He insists, no, I want to read the Quran. And then he does wudu. What happens? Subhanallah, he opens the Quran. Now this container is turned upside down now. It can be pouring with rain, this container will not become wet. As soon, subhanAllah, he says, what are you reading? This container has moved upside down. And he reads, Taha, ma anzalna alayka al-Qur'an al-tashqa. Then he reads a whole full verse. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, innani anallah, la ilaha illa ana fa'budni. That verily, without doubt, there is no deity except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except me. Allah says, fa'budni, has to worship me. He says, take me to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was on the journey to kill and assassinate Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, take me to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Sahaba, they were guarding Rasulullah because they knew Umar has come with a different intention. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, leave him alone. He comes, he says, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu annaka Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because he had the intention to change. What does Allah say? Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma bi qawmin. Hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim. So Ramadan will not change you. Your Umrah will not change you. Your Hajj will not change you. We have to change ourselves. So it is a reminder for me that we need to make this an objective in life. Just the way we have an objective in life. I need to earn £600 a week for my bills. I need to earn £1,000 a week. I need to have this. I need to have this. Why? Because, and we reach our targets. Why? Because we make an objective. We have to make it objective to change ourselves for the better. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. That person who follows Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in what avenue, if he changes his life, if he mourns his life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. Wallahi, this person has attained success in every shape and angle of life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us, me firstly, the ability to change myself. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to act more. Ibn Sayyid, Ameen wa akhidah.